Hey everyone, NASA made a huge announcement about the lunar landing system for the Artemis program today. I went ahead and did a cutdown of their teleconference. It was pretty long, it was about an hour, but this is really the tightest 5 or 6 minutes of the whole presentation today. So I'll let the NASA folks take it away to introduce the potential 3 lunar landers for the Artemis program. This was done today by Lisa Watson Morgan. She's the Human Landing System Program Manager. Douglas Lavero, who's the Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations, and their boss, Jim Bridenstine, who's the Administrator of NASA. So take it away, everyone.
Today, we are so excited to announce that we have awarded contracts to 3 companies who will begin the development on our integrated human landing system to return the next man and the first woman to the surface of the moon. One thing we were striving for with these solicitations and announcements is to see what U.S. industry could bring us with respect to innovation. And boy, did they deliver. We have 3 notably different architectures, from a 1-stage, a 2-stage, and a 3-stage architecture that achieves the innovation and the dissimilar redundancy of approaches that we wanted. The contracts were awarded in alphabetical order to the national team with Blue Origin of Kent, Washington as the prime, with Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper Labs as key partners. Blue's national team's design is a 3-stage architecture consisting of an ascent, descent, and transfer element. A unique aspect of the Blue Origin team is their ability to leverage the Orion heritage system for their ascent element from Lockheed Martin. Blue will develop the descent element, and Northrop Grumman will provide the transfer element. Their development approach includes an uncrewed lunar landing test flight for the descent element prior to human mission. The second one, in alphabetical order, is Dynetics of Huntsville, Alabama, who is leveraging over 25 companies as partners. The Dynetics design is a 2-stage architecture with a common ascend and descend element and anytime abort capability. It has a unique low-flung crew module, putting the crew very close to the lunar surface for safe access. Dynetics will perform a demonstration flight to verify key capabilities for its lander system. The third company that we awarded to is SpaceX of Hawthorne, California. The SpaceX design is a single-stage solution using their Starship concept. It provides extensive volume for the crew with 2 airlocks and ample downmass capability. It can land up to 100 tons of cargo on the moon. It builds off of their Falcon and Dragon heritage. The SpaceX proposal included in-space propellant transfer demonstration and an uncrewed lunar test landing. The diverse set of architectures and partners prepares NASA to perform the Artemis mission, and we look forward to a successful lunar landing in 2024 with U.S. industry.
We've got 2 prime objectives that the administrator talked to. You've got to get to the moon fast, and you've got to get there sustainably. And both of these objectives are key for our vision to accomplish what the nation needs to accomplish and what we've been asked to accomplish over these next several years. And make no mistake, this is not going to be easy. Even with all the work we've done, with all the work our partners have done, this is still going to be a lot of hard work. There are going to be many hurdles in the future for us to overcome. We've got to lock down the requirements for our systems. We've got to make sure they're focused on both of those objectives. We need to make sure we've got the right design, the right engineering, the right talent, and quite frankly, the right level of both commercial ingenuity and NASA good old lessons learned to put together to make this all work. So we are incredibly excited.
A couple of things that are important to note. The Gateway is critically important for what NASA is trying to achieve. Remember what we said. We need to do 2 things. Number 1, we need to get to the moon soon. Going fast reduces the political risk, but we also need to go sustainably. We need to be able to go and be able to go again and again and again. The challenge with Apollo is that it ended. So Gateway is important not just for reusability. It's important for sustainability. It's important for maneuverability. We need to get to the poles of the moon We need to get to the equatorial regions of the moon. And of course, Gateway is important for scientific reasons. It is also important to note that we have the priority is to get to the moon by 2024. We believe that getting to the moon by 2024 does not require the Gateway. In fact, I would go as far as to say that it's not likely that we will use the Gateway for the 2024 mission. The SOS and the European Service Module and the Orion crew capsule and the interim cryogenic propulsion stage, all of that is necessary to get humans to the moon by 2024. That's the only rocket that's going to be human-rated by 2024 that will take humans to the moon. When we talk about the landing system specifically, we need to get the landing system to the moon one way or another, and it doesn't have to go in an SOS. Our baseline solution is to launch the components independently and then aggregate them at the moon with automatic rendezvous and docking and then go down to the surface.
Well, there you have it. Apologies for the audio, everyone. It was a teleconference, so there's only so much cleaning up I can do. So these were the three potential lunar landers for the Artemis program, and I would like to reiterate that. They are now in the research and development phase of these three landers. NASA's been very clear that they want fast and sustainable. But these three landers offer a wide variety of options, with the Blue Origin option, I think, being clearly the lander option that's going to be the fastest, but maybe not the most sustainable because it's not very reusable, where you have on the opposite spectrum Starship, which is likely going to be very sustainable, but not very fast. I mean, it has a long way to go before being a reliable, iterative lunar lander system. So, you know, take that for what it's worth. I think that this is very exciting. I'm happy that we're in this position, and I would love to hear in the comments below what you all think about these three landers. If you want to see more videos like this, I try to do cutdowns and explainers and all kinds of other content in this realm of telling the beautiful story of human spaceflight, please subscribe to my channel or follow me on Twitter. I'm at TJ_Cooney. And if you'd like to be invited to my Discord, let me know in the comments and I'll send you a link. All right, and thanks for watching. I hope you learned something today, and I'll see you guys next time. All right, bye.